the oil and gas sector has remained quite volatile in the past few quarters, primarily on the account of the rising oil prices, which has led to concerns over subsidy sharing mechanism. Moreover, the government has been partially managing the auto fuel prices, which has led to earnings volatility for the marketing segment of the oil marketing companies. Overall, what we understand is that the upstream PSU, despite the concern of subsidy sharing, will be able to manage a net oil realization of $61 to $63 over next 2 years period. Plus, the oil and gas production is likely to ramp up, especially for oil ONGC, which will lead to strong earning CAGR of 11% over FY18 to 20 for ONGC. So ONGC remains our preferred pick amongst the upstream PSUs. We advise investors to avoid oil marketing companies IOCL and BPCL, basically from the fact that government will continue to intervene in the regulation of auto fuel prices, leading to volatility in the marketing earnings. So we advise to remain away from IOCL and BPCL, where we have neutral ratings. RIL is our top picks among the downstream and oil and gas space, given the fact that its standalone earnings will benefit from the recently commissioned ROGC and Petco gasification projects. This coupled with the gaining revenue market share in the telecom business and strong subscriber addition would lead to strong improvement in the earnings momentum for the digital services business. So RIL is our preferred pick among the oil and gas space. We have a buy rating on this stock. Amongst the midstream companies, Petronet LNG remains our preferred pick, given the fact that it is likely to report a strong jump in its volume, which is likely to grow at a 10% CAGR, as they will be commissioning their new 2.5 million ton Dahej capacity by in FY20, and also the Kochi terminal utilization will also improve to 40% in FY20 as the pipeline connectivity issues get resolved in Kochi to Mangalore section. So Petronet remains our topic in the midstream space.